outreach and gut. Let me tell you that Sam Montgomery will not play next week because he's injured. He got chop blocked. And so there's guys that go out there and fight like hell for us at risk of injury. And so it makes everything more important. It makes it more important to me. It makes it more important to this team. I like this team. I think this team will come together. I think this team will force out some of the fat and get the leaner meat. And at least that's how I hope it goes. I mean, certainly, it was not pretty. It was fun. I tell you right now, I don't know that I'm any more excited than I was to see the little yellow flag out there. And I'm going, what the hell was that for? I couldn't hear him when I talked. I threw my headphones off. And so I had to go ahead and call play because I didn't have anybody talking.
When you saw the flag, did you think it was four men on the field?
I had no idea. I had no idea. None. But I can tell you right now that the issue was, obviously, we were not in position to execute the play that we called. That was the mistake. Hey, we got them on. We were shy. Some seconds to execute the play that was called. Okay. The fact that we got them on and that we got the ball snapped was the difference. It allowed us then yet another play because of the penalty. Okay. Now, if we get them on a little bit better, we make a throw. We maybe win that one that way as well. Or if we clock it and run another run to the goal line personnel, that would have been the orderly fashion by which to finish the game. Okay. That one we'll have to do. I got to be real honest with you. I know we have advantages. So when it was an excellent call. Coach says, let's run this. Yeah, we got it. Let's go score. And when Jordan Jefferson went on right in, I said, that's going to score. Is there any question? It'll be a little short. Okay. Now, let's block it or let's have the other play called. It was a difficult scenario to get the two plays called and goal line personnel. I'm just telling you. So, we decided then to go with the other personnel, and that was the issue. So, now, questions.
Why bother with all the changes when you're 2 yards away and one room? Who called or who called or didn't call the two plays that were being called?
We had two plays called at one point in time earlier in that drive, and Coach Croker did. And then, he was the play caller during that series.
So, why the need for all the switch when you're a yard away from the goal?
The necessity of the run that we like, as opposed to just a run, or an advantage in play as opposed to just a play, that being the difference. In other words, we felt like we had some advantages. They hadn't seen us on the goal line. We're going to run a play that we're going to run in the end zone.
Did you sub back?
We eventually did.
Did you sub back to goal line on the play that you won
last play? Absolutely.
Can you get the clock play in any formation that you guys have, though?
I beg your pardon?
In any formation that you guys have, you can get the clock play at any time.
No question. Absolutely.
And so is there a signal from the sideline that can relay that?
Should have got that, you betcha.
It looked like was Jordan looking for the play? It seemed like Jordan, when he got on the field, was looking toward the sidelines for the play. Was he looking for the play?
We operated with two different quarterbacks during that time, too. I mean, it was the multiplicity of personnel, created certainly some of the issues. But I'm sure he was looking at, we operate with wristbands. Those guys got to handle those wristbands. And at times, that's difficult in itself. Imagine the pressure, the excitement, and the clock running down and having a wristband call.
What was Jared's role? The fourth and nine play when you had to play. Was the problem there? What was the problem there?
Quarterback needed more time. It was a quarterback call.
The play got in.
It was called.
It was in fast enough.
Coach, what was Jarrett's role coming into the game? Was he going in third series regardless?
Just like you saw. That was his role going into the game.
And will it continue moving forward?
I think we need to play both quarterbacks.
What are the advantages in your mind? I mean, more options, right?
Please. No, you're exactly right. I mean, some of the things that Jarrett does, he does as well as any, we need to fix some of those things. Okay, he needs not to make a couple of penalties, he needs not to throw a pick. Same thing with Jefferson. Jefferson, in my opinion, plays pretty good at times and then throws a pick. So we're a work in progress. And it's a group of guys who, in my opinion, have improved, but need to take some more.
consider starting Jared next game?
That's something that I, at this point, I'm not ready to say or see, or might be something.
After he threw the ball through the upright, it was 32 seconds to go, second down from the two. Did you think about two passes and then maybe keeping the run for the last play if he needed? You could have gotten three plays off in that situation.
I could have thrown two passes there without question. Again, it's wanting the play that we want that is the advantage, as opposed to just a play.
Right. Well, what about the clock? The clock part.
The clock should have been. We should have clocked it. It would have saved us the difficulty of moving personnel in and out. And we should have, when we put the goal line personnel back on the field, we should have had two plays. That's what should have happened. We should, or if we run the one, clock it, and then have the second play. It's the timing of the call is easy, and the issue then is. Let's just run the play versus the defense if they line up. Instead, we exchange personnel. That's the difficulty. We did not need to exchange personnel. We should have clocked or had the other play roll.
Why?